And joins us now with the latest. Dan, you've got information on what Mitchell Pearce got up to after he was thrown out of that party.
We have, Tracy. Now, the video ends with Mitchell and his group walking out of that apartment, but the night didn't end for Mitchell there. He was so drunk he actually left his mobile phone behind in the unit and then had to come back looking for it. He got his phone back, but instead of realising, OK, it's now really time to go home, he's headed to another pub in Sydney's eastern suburbs and somehow was allowed in that terrible state to continue partying there.
There has been fairly resounding condemnation of his behaviour today, but there have also been some people looking to shoot the messenger, and that is us, for reporting on what they argue was a private night out pre-season. Can we put that in context?
Well, it is the off-season, but and this was a club-sanctioned team bonding event, so they know that the players aren't... they were given the day off training to go and have this boat cruise, which we've, you know, seen photos of them all out there on the harbour having a nice Australia Day. But at the end of the boat cruise, the club gave the players taxi vouchers for them to get a free ride home. Many of the players took up that offer. A group of others kicked on to another pub. Mitchell was one of those. Then they left the pub and a whole bunch of players left again, but Mitchell's kicked on again with this smaller group of players and ended up here in this video. Now, why he thought that was a good idea, well, only Mitchell Pearce knows that. But today he left everyone else to deal with the fallout.
Just the one howling protester outside Roosters headquarters today as a media pack descended on the hunt for Mitchell Pearce.
I've got nothing to say.
Are you embarrassed? Do you think he'll be stood down?
Are you disappointed in your captain?
Oh, God, I've got nothing to say, sorry.
The captain was lying low, desperate to avoid the fallout from his Australia Day brain snap.
Exactly.
Roosters coach Trent Robinson left to front the media and outlined the club's response.
We at the Sydney Roosters have found that Mitchell's behaviour was unacceptable, and that's why he's been stood down up until this matter is resolved, and we'll go through that with the NRL over the next couple of days.
The video left most Australians stunned that a club captain could somehow think it was okay to behave like this.
The behaviour was unacceptable. We understand that. And at the Roosters, we can't accept that and we won't.
Totally unacceptable and irresponsible from a rugby league captain.
Jimmy Smith is a former Roosters player turned commentator. He believes Pearce needs to be checked into rehab immediately.
He's got to undertake that. I think that's really important, that he understands that he has a problem when he drinks and that he seeks the help that he needs.
It's not the first time Pearce has run into trouble on the drink. This was his last alcohol-fuelled incident when he infamously grabbed a woman in a yellow dress and ended up in police handcuffs.
What do you think about with Mitchell on the
Once again, he let his teammates cop the heat at training as he went to ground.
Did you witness the incident with the young lady?
Eventually surfacing on Roosters TV with an apology.
I just want to take the time to apologise to everyone for my actions the last couple of days.
On that occasion, he was fined $20,000 and dropped from the State of Origin team. It prompted Pearce to start a self-imposed alcohol ban. But his Instagram photos show he's been drinking quite a bit over the off-season.
He described himself as an erratic person. That's how he described himself to us just a couple of weeks ago, which is it's almost like a premonition now.
New South Wales State of Origin captain Paul Gallen is more concerned about the star halfback's welfare than the video.
He hasn't hurt anyone. His actions have only really affected himself, I believe, and hopefully he's okay.
Pearce is now feeling the heat on many fronts.
The RSPCA, like the general community, are appalled by Mitchell Pearce's behaviour as depicted on the video that aired on A Current Affair last night.
RSPCA Chief Inspector David O'Shaughnessy calling a press conference today to express his disgust at the football star's treatment of that poor dog.
There is specific legislation under the Crimes Act that deals with the inappropriate relations and interactions, including those of the sexual nature, between humans and animals, and the maximum penalties for those sort of offences are up to 14 years imprisonment.
Because the poodle wasn't injured, they won't be pressing charges.
Now, nobody wants to be dad on a boys' night out, but you do have to wonder when you look at the condition he was in, why someone hadn't tapped him on the shoulder before that and said, Mitch, go home.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it is a tough thing to do to be able to say that to someone, but you would think that somewhere along the line someone would have said, come on, mate, you've had enough. But, you know, we also got to remember he is the captain of the team. Mm. He's the guy that, you know, other players are looking to sort of lead them. So it's a tough one.
All right. Some people today want him in rehab, obviously. Some people want him sacked. What's likely to happen and who's going to make the decision?
Well, the NRL and the Roosters are working on that at the moment. Nothing is confirmed, but we're hearing it's likely to be a 6 to 8 week suspension. Whatever happens, Mitchell Pearce is going to miss the start of the season, either through suspension or through a stint in rehab, which we hear is almost a certainty. It's going to leave his team in a very difficult situation to be without their star player in a key position for that start of the season. He's apologised to his fellow players for his behaviour. We'd be expecting some sort of public apology soon too.
OK, thanks, Dan. All right, moving on now to the...